So we have two pieces of information here. We're told that 11 is equal to 8 plus f inverse of x minus 3, and that f of 3 is equal to 10. What I would like you to try is pause the video and figure out the value of x. So it looks a little daunting at first. You're like, wow, f inverse of x minus 3. And whenever you see something like this, at least my impulse is to at least just try to simplify the information you have and then see if we can make sense of it. So here, we could definitely simplify this equation by subtracting 8 from both sides, just so that we have f inverse by itself on one side. So if we subtract 8 from both sides, the left-hand side, 11 minus 8 is 3, and the right-hand side is f inverse of x minus 3. Or I could write this as f inverse of x minus 3 is equal to 3. So these are essentially our two pieces of information once we simplify this over here. And this seems pretty interesting because we say f of 3 is 10, and then we're saying f inverse of this right over here is equal to 3. So there seems to be something interesting going on. So we could even just think about what a function and inverse does. So this is the domain of the function, domain. And if this is the range, this is the range. We know that the function maps from 3 in the domain to 10 in the range. To 10 in the range. That's what the function does. But if the function does that, then the inverse function would map from 10 in the range to 3 in the domain. So this would be f inverse. So f inverse of 10 is equal to 3. Let me write that down. F inverse of 10 is equal to 3. So what this thing right over here is the same thing as that thing right over here. So 10 must be equal to x minus 3. So we could write x minus 3 is equal to 10. Add 3 to both sides. X is equal to 13.